little bit of life from the Yankees in the ninth inning, but definitely not enough offensive life.
This is an offense that averages better than 5 runs a game right now during their 4-game losing streak. 3.5, a team average under 200. The opponent average of 329. So nothing's clicking right now, Jack. The pitching, the starting pitching, the bullpen, for the most part, we've seen has struggled in this series. And then the offense has just been non-existent. And I do want to mention this, by the way, a 2-hour, 15-minute game yesterday, 2:33 today. We normally see those three and a half hour games because Yankees hitters were able to grind out at bats against starting pitchers.
I was just about to say that's the solution. And you want to give Porcello and Eovaldi credit because they're both strike throwers. And I thought they both pitched really good games the last 2 days. But the difference is exactly what you just said, Bob. The Yankees' inability to grind through at bats, to extend some at bats. What we saw in the ninth inning against Kimbrel was something that the Yankees haven't done across the first 17 innings or the last 17 innings of this series against Porcello and Eovaldi. When you look at the pitches per inning that Porcello and Eovaldi had, it's unbelievable. Eovaldi had 115 pitch inning and 116 pitch inning today, but most of them were 9 pitches, 10 pitches, 8 pitches. And you look at what they were able to do across the last 2 days, it's the first time since pitch counts have really been started tabulating that two pitchers went against the Yankees, pitched 8 scoreless innings at least, and threw 93 or fewer pitches. That comes from Jeff Quagliata in our research department. That's just amazing, and it speaks to how the Yankees just couldn't extend at-bats.
And obviously the thing is, do they miss Aaron Judge? Do they miss Gary Sanchez? Yes, but to this point of the season, they've had guys that have been able to pick up the slack, make them not so indispensable. Right now they feel indispensable.
Yeah, I thought of Judge too, because Judge obviously a guy who works at-bats, but Hicks usually sees a lot of pitches per plate appearance. Gardner usually does that as well. Stanton's a pretty selective hitter. But up and down that lineup, the Red Sox pitchers have just been able to carve up the Yankees. Today, again, with Eovaldi, it was that cutter, and the Yankees never made any kind of adjustment against it. Now, sometimes when it's got 8 or 10 inches of right-to-left movement, well, what kind of adjustment are you going to make? They just did not figure out a way to do any kind of damage against those two pitchers. Now they've got their first 4-game losing streak of the season. A very poor time for them, Bob, to suddenly go into this offensive malaise. And we've pointed out that this has actually been an extended poor run of poor play for them. They're now going on about a 6-week period where they've been a 500 or so team, and that's why the Red Sox have taken such a commanding position lead in that division.
You mentioned that they weren't getting deep into at bats throughout really yesterday against Porcello and against Eovaldi. That happened in the ninth inning. You wonder if that will at least maybe change tomorrow, or was it just an anomaly because it was Kimbrel in the game? Maybe it was different if Eovaldi was in the game. It's tough to tell, but they probably hope for some carryover.
Yeah, they do hope for some carryover. And if you're Aaron Boone, and we've seen him do this before, he searches through the shreds of negativity to find some positives. And that was a positive, the ninth inning. They did extend some at-bats against Kimbrel. I know that Porcello and Eovaldi are strike throwers, but Severino's a strike thrower too, and you saw how the Red Sox made him work yesterday. Sometimes it's just about flicking a ball away. Sometimes it's about not swinging at a pitch that maybe is right on the corner a few inches off, and I know it's tempting to swing at it, but you have to make these pitchers work. That's a hallmark of the Yankees this season. It hasn't been a hallmark of them lately, not these last 2 games against the Red Sox. And the Red Sox are feeling great about themselves. They had a call go their way on the challenge replay, yeah. And Alex Cora celebrated almost as if he just won the Super Bowl. They're feeling very positive about themselves, as they should. They've got the best record in Major League Baseball, on pace to win about 110 or 112 games. They're sitting pretty right now. The Yankees just trying to collect themselves and grab a win tomorrow at Fenway Park.
Yeah, now right now as they stand 8.5 up in the division. In the meantime, if there was a good thing happening for the Yankees, it's that Chance Adams got thrown into the fire at Fenway making his major league debut. Let's break down.